Hi guys, today we are going to look into LR parser, model of LR parser. L stands for left to right association, R stands for reverse of rightmost derivation, so that those two strategies are followed in LR parser. That is why it stands for LR parser. LR parser majorly classified into LR of 0, SLR of 1, LALR of 1, CLR of 1. These are all the major parsers. All the four parsers we are going to look at one by one. This is what your forthcoming syllabus. Now if you look at LR parser, in the case of LL1 parser, how the table was, there is no part of table. Here there is a stack, there is an input first of all. Next, there is an output. There is a stack data structure or stack functionalities or stack operations involved in this parser. A driver program. Driver program stands for algorithm, a routine or anything. That is a major part of your LR parser. Then parse table. These are all the component. Till this, the component of LR parser. These are all termed as component of LR parser. Normally, we consider one input. We will move towards the output only, stack, a driver program, and a parse table. So these are all the major component of parse, LR parser. Now coming to what is the difference, LR parser table will have two different functions or two different partitions, action portion, go to portion, or action function, go to function. Our action table, go to table. If you look at LL1 parser, we have constructed only one table. Now we need to construct two different tables. The two different tables are said as action table, go to table. Action table is meant for all the terminal symbols. Table is meant for all the non-terminal symbols. That's all. So this we must understand. This is the base. This is the difference. This is the point. LR parser changes from LL parser. LL parser also has input, output, stack operation, and table, driving program or driver program, driver routine, or an algorithm. Some algorithm to drive the parser, to carry out the parser. The same. And table, all the components are same. Only one portion where it is differing is table consists of two different partitions. Action table, go to table. Action table is involved with the terminal symbols. Go to table is involved with the non-terminal symbols. This much clarity you should have to step into that. Actually, to say the table construction will become end. Before that, we need to do a lot of computations. If you look at LL parser, we did a lot of pre-processing. Started cleaning ambiguous to unambiguous grammar. Ambiguous grammar to unambiguous grammar. We started cleaning left factoring. We started cleaning left recursion. Then we started computing first. Then we started computing follow. After doing these five steps only, we stepped into the parse table construction. If the grammar is clean, no need to worry these three steps. At least you should do first computation, follow computation. Only then you can step into the table construction. Similarly, here closure computation, that is a major part to start with LR parser. Closure computation is the major part that we should understand thoroughly. Otherwise, table construction will become difficult. If you look at in the LL parsing table, first and follow computation need to be done. Then that also should become perfect. Only then we can think of designing the table. Similarly, here as well, we need to be perfect with closure computation. Once closure computation is perfect, only then LR parser table will become perfect. These are all the differences. I'm comparing and contrasting. Look at this. There is a parsing program, LR parsing program or logic or the algorithm, anything you can call it as. There is a stack operation, there is an input operation, there is a table associated with this parsing program. That table consists of two different components, action and go to. All these four components together, parser program takes decision to produce the output upon this input. This is what written here. We started with input, output, stack, a driver program, and a parse table. That parse table consists of two components, action table, go to table. Action table is meant for terminal symbols. Go to table is meant for non-terminal symbols. This is the exact component depicted in this diagram. Nothing more, interchangeable. Either you start the diagram, then go with articulation, or do the articulation, then go with here. Now look at sequence of states. That and all, no need to worry. Sequence of symbols, how we are pushing. Similarly, A1, A2, A3 stands for number of symbols loaded into the input buffer. That and all, you no need to write that detail. You just write input buffer, you just write stack, you just write LR parser algorithm, LR parsing table, algorithm or driver program, whichever the word you feel suitable, you can write. Then there is a parsing table. That parsing table consists of two components, action table, go to table. This is introduction, no need even by heart. The steps which is involved when you are solving the problem, that you remember, that's more than enough. Then automatically you can write. It's a very largest problem. Let me go slowly, because today I'm going to lay the foundation. This is much more important for all the four parsers. Let me go slowly. Whenever you find difficulty, you need to question me. Only then I can clarify to you. That closure computation need to be thorough, because that closure computation is foundation for all the four parser, but it differs. Closure computation itself varies from parser to parser. That part no need to worry. But base of closure computation is similar. Now let us move on. See, then again further, that action table consists of shift action, reduce action, accept action, error action. Go to table consists of go to action. That much you no need to worry right now. This is the algorithm. The same steps I will be explaining while doing the table construction. Now let us move on to the problem. SLR of zero parsing. I'm going to rewrite zero parsing. You can write one also. What is the difference? SL of zero, SLR of one. One, if you put one symbol, look ahead. It will look ahead one symbol. Every day we look ahead our life, one day ahead. We will plan for another day also. If not for the short term goal or long term goal, we will plan for one. It will look at one more symbol other than the symbol under consideration. Like that. Listen, I am reading the letter S in my mind. I am reading letter S. While reading S, I will be following L also. I'll be keeping in mind the symbol under consideration and the subsequent symbol also. If I consider two symbols at a time, then it is called SLR of one. If I am not considering the following symbol, one symbol at a time, it is called SLR of zero. That much understanding is more than sufficient. If I put one more symbol, I am looking ahead. If I don't put one, only one symbol I am considering at a time. That understanding or clarity is sufficient. Let us move on. Now, this is a given SLR of one grammar. Hope so, this grammar is visible for you. Look at this grammar. This is the grammar we discussed in the earlier context as well. E produces E plus T, E produces T, T produces T star F, T produces F, F produces ID. Your first and primary duty should be numbering. How I have numbered? Given the production without any alteration, I started giving the numbering. One production, first production, two production, second production. Look at that. There are two productions or with the same LHS. Even then I have separated it out. these two productions having same LHS. I have separated it out. So you need to separate and unique representation you need to give, not with the augmentation form. You need to give unique representation form. Then you need to label all the given productions. First production, second production. Now, step number one. I'll just say, actually this other one is the step number one. Let it be. Step number one, number the productions. This is the primary step you need to do. I did it already. Now, let us go to step number two. What is the step number two? Let us see here. Step number two is involved with, I say, give me a minute, involved with two operations. One is including dot operator, another one is including augmentation production. Augmentation production, insert dot symbol. These are all the two operations we are trying to do here. Add augmentation production, insert dot symbol. What is it? I'll tell. Don't worry. Now, look at, this is the symbol we need to consider. Starting symbol. This is called start symbol of the given CFG. First production LHS we need to consider, that is the start symbol of the production. For that symbol, we need to do one augmentation production. One more. This is called augmentation production. It is standing out. It is entirely different. It stands out. This augmentation production, you need to always include with dash. You can use S dash, E dash, A dash, B dash, anything. Choice is yours. Right now, I am using the production called S dash. Hope so. Until this, you will be understanding. Very first step, this I need to consider. I need to shift it into right hand side. I need to augment the new production, S dash. If you feel confused, you can use E dash also, some new terminal. This all concept we discussed earlier, left factoring, left recursion. New symbol or new production augmentation, it is not so new. So that we have included new production, that production is called augmented production. For that augmented production, what you should do, you need to find out the start symbol. That start symbol, you need to do augmented production. So that I am doing S dash followed by E. Now this is a step number two. Let me push to the second step so that it will become bigger for you to understand. Now look at. So these are all the steps. Next step, not very simple. All the productions, what I am doing, beginning I am keeping a dot operator. Beginning of every production, I am keeping dot operator. There are five production, including augmented production. Now it becomes six, but there you should not number it. Never you should number. Original given grammar only we need to number it. Now just I am inculcating or including only the dot operator. Including dot operator. Guys, till then, are you clear? This is step number one, number the production. Step number two, add the augment production. This is my augmented production. That's why coloring it in different way. Next, insert dot symbol at the first position of every production in G. Clearly articulated. At the beginning of every production, I need to do dot operator. What is dot operator? What is the purpose of dot operator? How it will play a role? What is the significance of dot operator? Let us discuss later. Till then, only three steps included. Although I say it as step number two, it included two steps. One is adding augmentation production. Another one is adding dot symbol. Do you have got any doubt till then? Guys, come on, respond. Do you have any doubts?
Ma'am, doubt.
Okay. Shall I proceed?
Ma'am?
Yeah. Tell me, ma'am. Tell me, what is your doubt?
In For the second production one, ma'am, like T tends to dot T plus T. I think you should apply dot for T also, ma'am, in the
No,
second
no,
one
no, no.
because
No,
ma'am,
no,
I
no.
can write E as, I mean, E tends to T plus C also, no, ma'am.
No, no, I will explain you. This is a traditional model. Past 20 years, I did my BE in 94, 98. Those days also my teacher taught like that only. It is a kind of algorithm people invented and proposed. No need to go for your thought process. Just listen. What is this algorithm says? We need to obey. No more. If you think something fantastic algorithm that becomes a research, you can publish it. But here, no more alterations we can do. I'll just explain you. See, once again, every production you need to start with dot operator. No more. See, don't look at in between the production and all. Just look at, see, what is starting of this production RHS? Here, where my cursor is there? Here, I need to put dot. Where is the starting of this production? Here. Where is my cursor is there? Here, I need to put dot. Where is the starting of this production? Here, I need to put dot. Wherever I am giving this blue color cursor, we need to insert dot here. That's it. Simple. You think simple. You try to follow me. No need to think further. Just follow me. I'm asking you to put dot, 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 dot. Every RHS need to start with dot. That's all. I'll take you to the second step. Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Now, okay, ma'am. Now, what we are going to do? We are going for, I think so. I need to do with one table. Let me try. What way I can make you to understand? I not the, now closure computation we are going. Step number three or the further process is called closure computation. This is the terminology or technical terminology, technical meaning. Closure computation. First state, if you are confused with I naught, textbook follows I naught state. You can say state number one. Let us continuously go. State number one. What we are going to do, state number is directed graph we are going to draw based on closure. That is why I am telling state number one. Textbook conventional method says I naught state. State number one only they are keeping it as I naught. If you feel so complicated to follow I naught, simple, keep in your mind this is state number one. Now I naught equal to, I'm here if you feel again, state number one, right? State number one. I naught equal to, this I naught equal to, we are going for closure computation. Let me guide you for first time, then you can answer to me. See, I not equal to closure of substitute the first production. First production you are substituting. Just per substitute. How you are going to do is, see, this is the production you need to get output. Next, if dot followed by non-terminal, all its derivatives, all the productions of starting with E, we need to include. That is called closure computation. I will speak slowly. Look at the first production. S dash produces dot E. We are computing state number one or I naught. What for we are computing closure? First of all, we need to include that production. I am done. My state number one has this production. I am done. We need to look at dot followed by what symbol is sitting, whether it is non-terminal or terminal. That is the only two possibilities. No other possibilities. Dot followed by E. It is non-terminal. Because of it is non-terminal, I need to look at the original production. Which are all the productions starting with E? Production number one, production number two. Those two productions I need to include. While I am including, I need to use dot operator in the beginning of this production. I need to include the dot operator in the beginning of this production. This is the step number, very, very vital step of closure computation, first step. Let me question you. Do you have got doubt in this computation? We have considered this dot followed by E. dot followed by non-terminal. Because of non-terminal, I need to look at all the E productions. There are two E productions. E produces T, E plus T, E produces T. These two productions I need to write down first. I should not do anything else. Just I need to write down. Then I need to include dot operator, dot operator. Let me do step by step using table. You can understand. Yeah, one table is enough. Or two table. It's called closure I naught or I naught state or state one. Whatever name you want, but that consistency should be there. I should not change anywhere. State, either I should call it as I naught state or I should call it as state number one. What I am doing, S dash. My first production in this augmented production is S dash produces dot E. Dot E. This dot, I need to copy some other dot. I need to do dot E. This dot is much clear. So dot E. I need to look at, just I copy pasted. Nothing more I did. Otherwise, I will copy paste. Just I copy pasted. Next step, what I need to do, I need to look at the following symbol of the dot. It is non-terminal. Because of non-terminal, I need to look at the original productions, which are all starting with E. E produces E plus T, E produces T. I have copied. I need to paste or keep in your mind. That's all. What I am doing, these two productions I have copied. Next step, I need to use this dot operator in the beginning. Don't think that why you are not copying this, madam, since it is available here. I should not do. I'll tell you one by one. I need to look at the original grammar only. I need to bring all its derivatives. Then I need to start with the dot operation. This is how you need to do. If you have got doubt, you can clarify now itself. If not, let me proceed. This is the step. So that I am deleting this step next. Guys, if you have got doubt, you can clarify. This is the very first step, pivotal step you need to understand. Still, there are a lot of steps. After augmentation, dot operator, closure computation. Just now we started, only one closure computation we did. We need to do a lot of closure computation. If you have got doubt till this, you can question me. Don't think any other methodology by your own self. This is all, these are all the algorithm. So many great scientists invented long back before I born itself. So that we are following the same. These are all based for the academic context. Then if you think, if you have beautiful idea, wonderful idea, in order to do the closure computation or LR parser table design, you can propose it as a paper, not now in the academics. Now I naught computation is ready. Next. Look at, again, just because of this E, I have included these all. Similarly, look at this production again. The third production, if you look at, I'm applying bold. Because of this dot, I need to look at now this dot. Look at subsequent symbol, capital E. Because of capital E, I need to include all the E productions. Already it is done. That's why I am not repeating. I need to trace the third production. Dot followed by T. Because of this T, I need to go to the original grammar. I need to copy paste this grammar, or I need to include, not copy paste. Since online training, I'm telling copy paste. I'm including. After including only, I need to include this dot operator. After including, I need to include dot operator. So now I have included the dot operator. Look at this T got over. Next dot T. Dot followed by T. Just now I did because of T only, I have brought all the T productions. So no need to worry that we are fulfilled. We are fulfilled this requirement. Next production, look at dot F. Because of dot followed by non-terminal F, I need to look at the grammar, original grammar, whichever the production has F left hand side, I need to copy paste. Now I need to include the dot. Now this is the only one production not yet processed, this last production. Dot followed by ID, dot is followed by terminal. No more operations to be computed by myself. I need to stop. I not computation, I am done. S dash produces dot E. I have just taken this production. Don't say that you are imitating this only, madam. No, there is a concept behind it. I'll tell you. I started S dash produces dot E, dot followed by non-terminal. Because of that, I referred the original grammar. All the E productions I have brought. Then I have included dot, dot, dot. Then E, we have completed, fulfilled. So that I am going to dot T, all the T productions I have brought here, then included dot operator in the beginning, then F is a non-terminal. Because of that, I have brought F production, F produces ID, dot operator I have included, ID is a terminal. So my job is over. I am done with my job. No more job for me. So that, see, add all the productions with the T and F in modified I naught state, because dot is followed by the non-terminal. So the I naught state becomes. So this is the explanation. So let me remove this, not required. I'll write this explanation along with this so that it becomes kind of articulation or algorithm for you. Now I am going for step number two. Step number two means what? I1 state or state number two, another state computation. I'll give you a holistic picture so that you will understand. See, look at this is the diagram we are going for last. If you look at this diagram, these are all the productions we started first. Augmented production, because of that we have done this, we have done this, we have done this, we have done this, we have done this. That is called I naught. Upon E, E alone, where we went, S dash produces E dot, E produces E plus T. So this is what we are computing. I1, that dot operator need to be shifted. Look at here, E dot. If you cross the E, that is called E label. Then you should cross the T, then it is called T label. If you should cross F, that is called F label. You should cross dot, that is called ID label. You need to shift this dot operator. You are starting at the beginning of the production. Every time you need to shift, shift, shift. Whenever this S dash produces E dot, that dot should go end of all the production. Whenever for this all the six production dot goes end of the production, you will be stopping that process itself. Look at here, there is a dot, here there is a dot, not available. Let's see, here there is a dot, here there is a dot, here there is a dot, here there is a dot. The dot operator reached the end of production. I could not able to annotate. If at all, I try for annotating. Look at this is the production E dash ends. E dash ends. Look at here. Next. Again. This is the production T dash ends. Next, I need to draw here. This is the production F dash ends. This is the production T dash ends. This is the production T star F dash ends. This is the production E plus T dash ends. How many productions we have? Six production. I have drawn six arrows. If you look at within that circle, these all the original six production ends with dot. So that only I am completing this directed graph. Otherwise, this graph would be expanding. It will go larger and larger. So these are how to draw this graph only, our attempt, our steps. That is where we are working on. So far now we did I naught computation. We did dot E because of E, all the E productions have been brought here. Dot T because of T, all the T productions have been brought here. Dot F because of F, all the F productions have brought here. So then dot, 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 everywhere it seems to be dot. Next step, we need to consider within this production, one production at a time we need to consider. If we consider the first production, right hand side, dot E is available. We need to cross the dot. Whenever we are crossing the E, look at, there are two productions are available with E. So then we need to consider both of the production to cross the E. Whenever dot operator is crossing E, that label should be marked with E. That edge should be marked with E. So that these two grammar, these two productions are completed with crossing E. Now we are looking at T operator. Whenever we are considering T, all the availability of T we need to consider. There are two productions available with T. We need to cross T. Because of crossing T, I am marking this label T. I need to cross the T. Next, look at dot dot. I crossed the T. So that T dot T dot. Next, what I am doing, I need to cross F. Only one production available with dot F. So that crossing F, T produces F dash. Then next production, ID. Only one production labeled with ID. So that ID dot ID. Now this is the step we reached. Now I need to focus on this production. One production have been completed. Next production, dot followed by plus. I need to cross the plus. Whatever plus is available, all the production I need to consider, but only one production. So I am crossing the plus. Next, what we are doing? E plus dot T, because we crossed the dot, dot plus the dot, we are crossing the plus. So that plus dot, dot followed by T. Now the danger comes. Dot followed by non-terminal. So far now, everywhere in these four steps, dot followed by terminal or end of the production. See, look at here. Dot is at end. Dot is followed by plus. Dot is followed by star. Dot is at end. Dot is at end. Dot is at end. Next, if you look at this grammar, dot is followed by capital T. Because of that, all the T productions I need to bring. Dot T. T produces T star F. T produces F. I need to start with F dot. Then because of dot followed by T, already we did it. Dot followed by F, we need to bring this production. These three productions we are brought from the original grammar. Next, T produces T. We need to cross star. See here. This star should cross the dot. Sorry, dot should cross the star. So that's star. Star dot. Dot followed by F. Because of non-terminal, we need to bring F production. F produces ID. We reached here. Next, look at this. Next, shift this dot operator. Shift this dot operator, T. Now, because of that, E plus T dash, because of shifting dot operator, I said all the T you need to consider at a time. Dot T is available here once, here once. T dot, T dot. T dot is end. Dot star is terminal. Next, look at here. This dot star you need to move on. Then if you are moving on dot star, T produces T star dot F. Because of F, you need to include the production. F produces ID. You need to start with the dot ID. Next, look at this production. You need to cross this F so that F label. T produces T star F dot. That is what we have discussed so far now. These are all the four arrows we need to discuss it. Why we need to discuss these four arrows? I'll do step by step also. Don't worry. Now look at within this production, there are three productions not yet processed. Dot T, we need to move dot T because of dot T we did here. Next, dot F. Move this dot F. F label. If you move dot F, it will be repeating. T produces F dot. If there is a new set computed, we need to give a new label, new circle. If it is existing circle, we need to redirect there. Similarly here, dot we need to shift. If we shift dot, I4, F produces ID only will come. Similarly here also you need to shift dot. It will come to this production only. Similarly, you need to shift the star. Then it will compute this production only. Look at for a while. Almost we reached the end of the hour. I'll do the step by step, but this is a holistic picture. This is what I am aiming to do. For that, I naught I have computed. With the I naught computation, we have reached to the DFA. This is directed graph or directed flow graph, deterministic finite automata, anything you can call it as. This is directed flow graph or directed graph. So our ambition is to compute this. This is what I mean to say state. I naught, I one. You can label it as state number. You would have studied in the formal language also. State number can be anything. So I one, I two, I three, I four, I five, I six, I seven, I eight. Whenever the existing combination arrives, we are redirecting to the existing node instead of creating new node. If you create new node, you will be duplicating. You will be increasing the complexity. That is why we need to do at the end.